Hello, welcome to the self-learning podcast by Dr. Sushma Singh. Let us start discussion on Unit 15, Entrepreneurship and Capitalism. In this unit, Entrepreneurship and Development of Capitalism, as analyzed by the social scientist to the theoretical understanding, has been discussed briefly. Efforts have been made to analyze that how social sciences can provide new and fresh ideas about the theory of entrepreneurship and development of capitalism. While analyzing this, theoretical foundation of the classical thinkers Weber and Schumpeter has been identified. When classical theory of economics on its strength was rejected by the German historical school, Weber's theoretical assertion had become meaningful on its theoretical ground. It has been described in the coming section. Weber's idea on entrepreneurship is generally identified with the theory of charisma. The perspective to which this theory is able to demonstrate the development of capitalism in the primitive stage of society is appeared in the subsection. Also, this section presents how Protestant ethos has provided such a social condition where entrepreneur achieved social acceptance and led development of capitalism, which was not available before the Reformation. While subsection of this unit deal with Schumpeter's contribution of entrepreneurship with reference to the theory of economic development and his economic, psychological and sociological perspectives have also been identified. How for Durkheim's idea can be useful to understand entrepreneurship has been tried to develop in subsection, and some ideas of modern sociologists have also been incorporated in this section. Finally, summary of this unit is given. Now let us move to the point, meaning of entrepreneurship. There is some unresolved controversy regarding the meaning of entrepreneurship. Also, there is some consensus about the entrepreneurship, which includes a part of administration and its function in decision making process for regulating some types of organization. Some scholars refer to the term for strategic or innovative decisions, while others apply it for the business organizations. The term can be clarified in the historical context. The genesis of the word is French, which appeared long back, particularly to denote to do something. During early 16th century, those who were engaged in leading military expeditions were labeled as entrepreneurs. After 1700, the word was frequently referred to by the French for government, road, bridge, harbor and fortification contractors, and later to the architects. By 1800, the word appeared in the academic discipline as it has been used by a considerable number of the French economists, who treated the word in a specific sense in the field of economics that has given special meaning to entrepreneur and entrepreneurship. with differences emerging mostly from the features of the sector of economy. And those economists who were interested in government treated the entrepreneur as a contractor, agricultural specialist or farmer, and industrialist as a risk-taking capitalist. However, entrepreneur and entrepreneurship have been used in various contexts in the scholars at various points of time. Now, let us move to the next point, theoretical background of entrepreneurship with special reference to Max Weber and Joseph Schumpeter. Max Weber and Schumpeter, though they belong to sociology and economics respectively, have contributed to develop theory to analyze entrepreneurship and its role in the development of capitalism in society. Both theorists, with respect to their ideas and theories, have some consensus and some differences. Schumpeter paid attention on identifying pre-scientific vision, hence he made the task rather easier and assumed entrepreneur merely a manager in the circular flow of development system. So far as Weber's ideas are concerned, it is difficult task to make an identification as his thoughts on entrepreneurship are often scattered in his works. Nevertheless, the Protestant ethic and the spirit of capitalism can be identified at a point of departure, which he built up with some theoretical foundation to understand the development of capitalism. Both scholars, varying in their interests, have formulated social theories and economic sociologies, which up to some extent are similar in scope and theoretical conclusions. Many analogies can even be attributed to Marx, and many are yet to be explained. Schumpeter, though, took the idea of Marx in analyzing social aspect of entrepreneurship and tried to link with the development of capitalism. His approach and conclusions are very much non-Marxian. Weber also in this context is not exception, whose treatment of social phenomena is not different with Schumpeter. Weber's conception on attack on Marx's idea of materialistic explanation of history was too a challenge to the economics as an autonomous scientific discipline. This situation has been explained by Bendix, as Weber has demonstrated. Economic conduct was inseparable from the idea with which men pursued their economic interests, and these ideas had to be understood on their own terms. At the same time, scholars of Germany historical school had been involving in asserting it for many years and rejecting classical economic theory on its strength. The new situation which emerged was Weber's assertion of entrepreneurship and development of capitalism on theoretical ground. Schumpeter stated that his exposition on entrepreneurship and development of capitalism rests on the fundamental distinction between static and dynamic situations. Both have formulated the theoretical structure at about same points of time. Skimpeter was trained in Australian tradition of economic theory and Weber in German historical school. Now let us wind up the session and take rest. Thank you very much for engaging yourself with the self-learning podcast.